Let us focus on some of the points which has been suggested to Council of Architecture. So I have just sharing my laptop screen, and you can see here they have advised the name of the act, many amendments as the Architects Act 1972, which I personally feel the name cannot be same. It has to be the Architects Amendment Act 2020. And the purpose of the act they have mentioned, it is they have kept probably the same. I have advised the act is to provide the regulation of the architectural education and registration of architects and for matters connected therewith. So I have included that it has to include the regulation of architectural education also, earlier which was missing. And the name, of course, which I already said, the Architects Amendment Act 2020. It cannot be same, it has been taken by the. Now the very crucial point which comes to the definition class 2 here, you can see the architect means a person whose name is for the time being in the registers, the architect, in their suggestion, the Council of Architecture has kept it same. But as for my view, the architects mean a person whose name is for the time being entered in the register, and there is a need to include and provides the architectural services which is shown in that. You can see it here. Now the most crucial part is that you have to define the architectural services. So I have added some of the wordings which you can see in red. The concept I have added, pre-feasibility I have added, layout plan I have added, site and spatial planning development I have added, and here and preparation and documents and related to construction and completion, renovations and sites others related to the matters. Because I personally feel the architectural services here which are given by the Council of Architecture in their amendments, it's not seems to be very doesn't seem to be holistic, so we have to take some holistic. So I have added some of the wordings, you can read it in continuity and you can make out something. Now another suggestion which I have given, that council means the Council of Architecture India. So here they have added India word there which is missing. So I have advised if they can take the name Architecture Council of India, ACI, as Bar Council of India, Medical Council of India. These are just my suggestions. And next, I would request to add companies also and to restrict their MOA, to limit their objectives. They have to provide the architectural and allied services only. Because if you stop big companies to come up in this profession, it will just create hindrance for the bigger companies to come up. And earlier, what is the thought process by all of us, the Architects Act limits our working style, and we are not able to work on the basis of that foreign architects are doing, and we are not able to bid for the bigger projects due to our turnover limitations and other things. And here I have suggested they have added the professional examinations mean an examination conducted by the council for granting registration certificate of practice. So here I feel there is some confusion. Granting registration is same as the architectural practice, COP, certificate of practice. As per me, it should be different. So I have requested them, advised them to change name architectural professional examination, AP, rather than to keeping it professional examinations. Means an examination conducted by the council for granting registration of the certificate of practice. So here I need a clarification. Registration and COP is same, or these are something else. After registration, some COP will be issued separately. And here again, I have suggested that the name of Council of Architecture India can be Architecture Council of India. It may be considered as per my suggestion. And next, when we come to other suggestions, so here in the Council of Architecture, when we talk of the members, so I have requested them to differentiate between UG and PG members. There should be clear-cut demarcations. How many from undergraduate, BR level, how many from MARC level or master course levels. And next, I have advised architects from each state oblique union territory, and it's same, almost same, which the Council of Architecture advised. There is no major difference in this. And next, all seems to be okay here. In next classes, when we come further, we have come up to class 7, 8, 9, 10. You can go through all these classes. These are connected with the Council of Architecture internal working. Now, I had advised in earlier video also that allowances of the staff of the Council of Architecture should be fixed by the Council of Architecture, not by the government. They have considered this, but they have not considered what is the basis of this. They should mark this also, because all the employees are treated as government employee as per the council, as per Architects Act 1972. So they should mark here. So here there is no change. They have advised the qualifications undergraduate as recognized. They have divided into undergraduate and postgraduate qualifications as notified. So there is no suggestion from my side. It seems to be okay. Further, the such qualifications should be recognized in the first place for the next 5 years. This is okay. Now we come to here. So here the class 17, anything contained. Now it said the every authority in India shall take prior approval from Council of Architecture introduction of the architectural course with the definite intake. This is already IFCAS. In fact, this is already in practice. So here what I suggested, here in the class 17, not withstanding anything contained in any other law, but subject to the provision of this act, any recognized qualification shall be sufficient qualification for enrollment in the register. No. Here, now since they have introduced this professional examinations, which I am trying to name as APE, that qualification will be sufficient not for the registration, but in fact for the appearing in the APE or getting COP, Certificate of Practice. So here they need changes, because these two things are contradicting to each other. At the one instance, they are saying they will have to pass exam, professional exam. Now they are saying it will be sufficient for registering. So there is a contradiction. I think there is some confusion there. It must be clear. And here in 19 class, as the Council of Architecture representative go to various institute to cross-check whether they are going, their regulations are meeting the norms or no. So I've advised to remove this name inspector and to give a name observers and reviewers, because as per me, inspector name is not fit to our professions. We should not be treated as inspector when we go to the other colleges for the investigation. So better we should be treated as observer or reviewer, because our work is to observe and review. So this is just my suggestion. And here observer receiver's duties have been told here in this subclass 2, has been advised by the Council of Architecture. I have again changed the name in the place of inspector to do observers and reviewer. And I have added that they should also check the statutory approvals, which is not mentioned in this as per the amendments advised by the Council of Architecture. Now further, I think there is no change further. Respective, they avoided respective words, because now they are saying UG plus PG. Earlier the post graduation was not included, since they have included is this, so they are using the terms respective in terms of UG as well as PG. So okay, there is no issue here. The board which will conduct the exam for professional examination, which I am saying architects professional exam is named to be given, it should consist of both practicing architects as well as academician. This is my suggestion, because this is for the practice. So anyway, it may be a broad policy. Further, they may add some regulations on the basis of this. Here the council may by the regulation prescribe standard for professional conduct and etiquette, shall. I have said it not may, because are there further this will lead to litigations and then interpretation will be sought. So it should be shall. Certainly, the Council of Architecture is a premier body, statutory body. They have to form these professional etiquettes and conduct, so it should be shall, not may. Now we come to chapter 3. The name of when we register the architects in the register of the Council of Architecture, their workplace also be separately mentioned. So they have not mentioned here. I have added that should be added. Further, I have suggested there is no suggestions in the registration. So we are now come to chapter 3. Here I have again advised the private limited company should be added to expand our scope of working by restricting the MOA of the private limited company, so that we can go work at architect and work at bigger scale. They should be able to raise private funding for working of themselves to raise their standards at the international level. After passing the professional examinations, here I have added that along with this qualifying examination certificate, they have to submit the required documents which are required. It was missing. We have to be very thorough when we read this point wise point, word by word, No, it has to be, it has to have some meaning so that afterwards there should not be any challenges to this. I am not perfect in this, but I have tried to go through all the contents in Toto and tried to find out the meaning of that. Here I have raising the same thing, whether registration and COP are same or these are difference. Because earlier in practice we were used to provide a registration certificate after registering. There was nothing like COP. COP, the certificate of practice concept is good, but it should be very clear-cut demarcation between registration or COP. If it is same, then it should be clearly mentioned. Then I come to next point here. What are the other amendments? I have advised chapter 3rd is okay because it covers the registration of the architects. Then I come to chapter 4, it is miscellaneous, where we had a dispute in 36, 37 class. So there much more to do because the title has been being protected there already. Now the services is to be protected and the sole responsibility of these services has to go in favor of the architects only. So there is no, they have covered already, Council of Architecture have covered, but I have suggested minor amendment. In the case of some, you know, cases, the cases against architects when go to various courts. So this presidency architects magistrate is nowadays, it's not a common magistrate of first class, rather because it's a technical matter. So I have advises that a law tribunal should be formed in this so that they should listen to our case and tribunal should be there. There should not be any, you know, magistrate or first class because these are technical matters. The tribunal, we can have a technical person, maybe from architects faculty, so that he is able to understand the various nitty-gritties involved in the that functioning. So he should be understand. So tribunal word I have suggested it should be done. And the affected party, I mean the architect, should have a right to appeal in the high courts of its jurisdiction. Of course, the legal recourse it should, but it is not mentioned, so I have added that in this. So these are the just suggestions. Rest is seems to be okay. There is nothing much more. And now the decision about the inquiry and the result of the inquiry, consequences of the inquiry should be on the basis of equity, good conscience, and natural justice. It should not be as may be deemed fit and report to the central government. It should not be. There should be some basis, and basis should be equity, good conscience, and natural justice. This I have added. These are very few suggestions here. What I have given to Council of Architecture, I have already sent. I think there is no further suggestions. The seems to be covered. Thank you very much for being with me. So there are not much suggestions because the amendments has to be like amendment. It should not be a total turn around in the concept. So I think you have understood in the various chapters what suggestion I have given. Thank you very much.